In 1913, Lee D. Forrest, the inventor of the Triodos tube, was charged by the district attorney for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stock of his company. You may not understand what the meaning of it regarding, because Lee D. Forrest is, who is in the vocabulary you can see, an American inventor with over 180 patents. Patents means the person who invents or who discovers something, then the authority or the things, you know, what is the method that he has created will be with him. If he wants to share it with others, that is called patent. So if somebody invents something, if a medicine, and now you see coronavirus vaccines, people are planning to find out the vaccination, no? So when the vaccine is found out by a country or a medicine, a medical company, they will have the patent. Then they have to sell it. If suppose India is finding out the vaccine for the coronavirus, if India has to share, if America needs it, the patent has to be taken from India or the company which you have found out. So that is why. So this man has found out many inventions, and he had 190 patents of his credit. He invented the audition, a vacuum tube that takes relatively weak electric signal and amplifies them. He is one of the father of the electronic age, as an audience helped to usher in the widespread of use of electronics. That is in the electronics lens, how it is being shared. You might have studied in physics. He is also credited with one of the principal inventions that brought sound to motion pictures. No? Pictures and the sound, what we see in the TV and all, or the motion of the sound from. Now you see more back to the chapter, you can understand again. For his company, by claiming that he could transmit the human voice across the Atlantic. When I was asking the students who are coming to the school, how the sound of can be transmitted to across the Atlantic, no? One place to another, is it possible? No, from I am speaking from one side of Louisville, the other side of Louisville who are there, is it possible to transmit my sound? They said no, but it is possible. That is the use of the mobile phones, the phones. So, in the year of 1913, when this man said the sound can be transmitted from one place to another, so such a far, they said no, it is not possible. So he was arrested. He was publicly humiliated. Can you imagine where we would be without this invention? Now he's saying, if that was not found out, where would have been the world today? So it was possible, but he was humiliated. He was already the court has told that he has made people cheating. So that is the way. So that is what you understand. Again, coming to a New York Times editorial on December 10, 1903, questioned the wisdom of the Wright brothers. Who is Wright brothers? The persons who found out aeroplane. The Wright brothers were trying to invent a machine heavier than air. That would fly. So those days it was not even cutting, wind comes, if wind is smaller wind, the feathers will fly. If it is little higher wind, the leaves will fly. So what is less heavier than the wind only can fly. The weight of the body as well as the gravity of the air, this all depends. But here Wright brothers said, no, something can fly. So, the New York Times questions in that 1903, that would fly. 1 week later at Kitty Hawk, the place, the Wright brothers took their famous flight. You can search the YouTube, you can find out how the Wright brothers flew the first plane. No? So this is, when they were trying to invent something, it was not allowed. They were humiliated. Again, Colonel Sanders. This is very interesting. Colonel Sanders at the age of 64. In the vocabulary, these people's names and their discoveries have been mentioned. You just to go through. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Here, Colonel Sanders at the age of 65, with a beat-up car. Beat-up car means very damaged old car. and a $100 check from Social Security. What he has received, a Social Security of $100 check, he realized he had to do something. So he, when at the age of 65, he thought he has to do something. He remembered his mother's receipt. What is a receipt? No, receipt means a particular way of preparation. So cooking, no, receipt. Some people will prepare in certain ways. So here, his mother's receipt, he remembered and went out selling that. Prepare something with that preparation. Went out selling. You know, he carried what is his mother's receipt, which mother might have been dead, but that special preparation prepared, and he went over selling that. How many doors did he have to know? How many, so many doors went on, you know, some people, you want this, you want this, some people come, you know, and now I see in employees colony, mornings, there are many people, vegetables, some people come with the vegetables, some people come with the clothes, some people with the other things, so they will go on, we have this one, if you want, come and buy, so like this, he was going after door to get his first order. It is estimated that he had knocked on more than 1,000 doors. More than 1,000 doors he has knocked before he got his first order. More than 1,000 doors he had to knock before he got the first order. How many of us quit after 3 tries? No. After 1,000 doors when he knocked also, he was getting only his first order. Now we try one time, two times, three times, he say 3 tries, sometimes 10 tries, I am tired, or some people 100 tries, tired. And then we say, we tried as hard as we could. So this man, now he, who is called as Carol Sanders, you know, he is the inventor, he is the person who found out KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken. Now what is KFC, you know? How much demand it has got all over the world. No, when you say about KFC, if you go to Vijayawada, some cities, Mars, and we have KFC, you have to see the rush there. So the receipt, the powder that mixing with the chicken and all, no, is very, very precious. Now when I was saying about KFC, people were very happy. Now this man, 1,000 doors he knocked to get the first order. But now the condition. So this is it. Don't keep away your willingness to succeed. And we go on, proceed. And again, as an young cartoonist, Walt Disney, no, Walt Disney is the cartoonist famous one, faced many rejection. So this, he was a cartoonist, he was drawing and sending from newspapers. When he sent to a newspaper, they will say, throw it out, not useful. And who said, you have no talent, don't you have talent to draw like this? This is not. One day, a minister at a church, minister in the church means the person, no? In the church and all, in the temple also, we have church, we have priests, pastors, in the temple we have the pujari, who the one who do the works, no? The offering works. So these people are called minister of the church here, hired him, you know, you ask him to come with me to do something, to draw some cartoons maybe for the church. Disney was working out of a small mouse infested shed near the church. So working, Disney was working out of a small mouse, you know, a small mouse in infested shed near the church. After seeing a small mouse, he was inspired. So when he saw the small mouse, he was so much inspired. That was the start of great Mickey Mouse. You know, Mickey Mouse cartoon, how much people are eager and liking for that. So this is was another successful story. Again says, successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in great things. Doesn't mean that you are doing so many great things. Rather, they do the small things in great way. Okay, I end this section now. We will move on to the next section, next class.